if you've seen that poem, I normally just kind of crack out a couple of funny poems, but I'll start the night with a love poem. It's called My Bird's This. No matter what the time of day and in their bed at night, my bird's ass makes all sorts of noises which often smell of shite. She does her best to deny the noises that she makes. Even when they don't make noise, I feel her body shake. Sometimes I need to hold my breath and sometimes it's a laugh. Maybe it's not so romantic when we are in the bath. But even when she does her best and hides a massive fart, my bird has got a lovely ass and that's what won my heart. I was here last time and I done a poem called Superbam, and at the end of it says, I'll do a Superbam too. This is a Superbam returns. It's the return of the Superbam. I tell you, I'd be back. I've done it. I've had a wee bit of surgery just to sort out my saggy sack. Because putting on my socks one morning, I brought my foot up to the bed. And once you've stood on your own, boys, there's time for a sack tuck instead. Still can't fit into my costume. I've yet to lose a few more stains. But I'm back to shooting lasers out my eyes because I knew their contact lens. Still can't fit into my costume. I fucking said that. I'm still fucking grounded. As you see, I'm still too heavy. I can't fucking help myself because I still enjoy a baby. Oh, fuck. And so stop saving cunts and letting bad things just naturally happen. I'd rather sit getting super pissed in my hero's lair, the band cabin. Well, there's plenty of superheroes that are in it purely for good. The perfect fucking Superman and that wee Spidey dude. I can't be asked to hoff them, they're weird and all inbred. So I've started thinking about the local cunts. Quality Man and Mega Ned. They're a couple of fucking bangers. I'm not sure I've made the right choice. Mega Ned could start a fight with Sale and Quality Man just keeps shouting Quality Man. You want to see the shit we got up to though? We mostly just have a good laugh. Except when we see cunts taking liberties, then we keep them mailing about up the ass. We fans that rip off your granny or bully your fucking wings. The worst cunts we deal with are pedos. Real superhero work, you know what I'm saying? Nobody wants to see that one film or make a comic book of us. And so here I stand telling poems when I should be super punching cunts in the bus. I maybe should never have done this, trying to put out a decent sequel, but following the superhero franchise, you know I'll just need to do a prequel. A story of how I became Super Bam long before my hair started thinning. Keep your eyes and ears peeled then for Super Bam, the beginning. Thank you. Yeah. So this poem's called Size Matters.
Of course it is.
If you've ever been told size doesn't matter, you've been fucking lying. My missus tell me. Size matters. See my missus, she loves 12 inches, she take it every time. She makes us feel like a prick when I'm only give her 6. I feel like I committed a crime. She ain't been impressed, but I've tried my best and 6 is all she's getting. There's a glimmer of hope when she reaches the group and we get into some heavy petting. She likes it hot and it's what I've got. You know I'm being a rapscallion. But there's no surprise when she's satisfied with my 6-inch spicy Italian. It's not exactly cricket knowing how to work her ticket. To my woman's heart there's just one way. When it's nearly lunch, go past for a munch and get a favourite in via Subway. Setting that to fucking Subway on Twitter and then they didn't reply now. Cunts are doing fucking adverts on TV. Now, featuring poetry, I thought that'd be fucking classic, man. Fucking balance. Right, we're serious one. This one's called Antisocial. Because I'm an antisocial cunt, really. I don't hate you, I hate every cunt. I'm fucking antisocial every day, week and month. I don't want your life story, I don't want to make small talk, I can't listen to your pish to take yourself for a walk. I just don't have the patience to listen to your woes. It's going in one ear out there and it's curling up my toes. I don't care if you had a good holiday or what you done on your day off. Tell me something interesting for a change maker's laugh. I've got enough shite going to the end heed, shite I don't want to share. And I don't want to, I'm not ready to share cunts. I don't want my life to get there. Fuck off, I'm going to admit. I know the problem's all mine. I know I've come across as a prick, but I'd rather you knew where you stood. and in my head I'll stay sick. One day or another, I'll get back to the way that I used to be. It's no plain sailing with me.
Fuck off.
I'm really sorry, everyone. I'm fucking doing miserable right now. Really fucking sorry, pal. That's fucking annoying. It's annoying me. I'm gonna go to pee, but I won't. Fuck. Let's start again. I'm really sorry. Two nights in the trot, I fucking fucked up big time last night. What a cunt. I don't hate you. I do, I love everybody. I don't hate you, I hate every cunt. I'm fucking antisocial every day, week and month. I don't want your life story, I don't want to make small talk. I can't listen to your piss, you'll get yourself for a walk. I just don't have the patience to listen to your woes. It's going in one ear out there and it's covering up my toes. I don't care if you had a good holiday or what you've done your day off. Tell me something interesting for a change maker's laugh. I've got enough shit going on my head, shit I don't want to share. And I'm not ready to tell cunts, I don't want a life lead out there. I know the problem's all mine, and we'll come across as a prick. But I'd rather you knew where you stood, and in my head I'll stay sick. One day I'll go and see a shrink, but no till I'm getting ready. I know it's no plain sailing with me, but I'm doing my best to keep steady. I wasn't always like this, I used to go on the empty. I'm not sure when or what caused the change, but I'll sort it when I'm getting ready. Cause I can't go on this way, being a bad tempered, unsociable twat. It's no good for me and mental health. Maybe I should change my health habitat. One way or another, I'll get back to the way that I used to be. It may take a wee while longer than hoped, and so I apologise for me being me. Thank you. Thanks very much. I'm going to try and make an ass from selling it. Well, this time anyway. So I wrote a poem about Buckfast a while ago, and it was because I fell for a Facebook post when they said that the minimum price of alcohol was coming in and the Buckfast was going to be £20 a bottle. I wanted to have my fucking nut and wrote a poem because I was drunk. Here we go. It's made the monks forgiven, the Saint Benedictine kind, and they produce this great wee drink called Buckfast tonic wine. It's drank by fucking all sorts, but it's got a right bad rep. You're just a fucking hooligan, or even worse, an egg. You'll never drink it out the glass, you'll never fill the bottle. Well, what hooligan or egg do you know that isn't antisocial? I'm not sure why it gets the blame for violent acts of crime, cause I just get drunk and chill the fuck out when I'm drinking mine. I've seen the Buckfast challenge, but I haven't done it myself. Maybe that's how I haven't woke up in a random police cell. Well, actually I have. But when they called a bucky, I was just a bitty a thug who thought he was fucking Rocky. I see a drop since then, I've not had a fight in years. I still like a drink right enough, a bottle of tonic and a few beers. But if the rumours are true, and the alcohol volume drops, I'll be finding something else to drink, because the effects of bucky will be crap. So I hope my monk mates will stand up for a consumer and fight for alcohol rights. We don't want to drink that Eldorado pish or any other wanty wee shite. Cheers. Hey, one minute. You've heard this one on Bobby before, but fuck it. It's called Come Back Bobby. I think this deserves a wee bit of fucking music for a minute, but fuck it. They've been a day and they've been doing it. As a bit of a rap, so here we go. I'll try not to forget it. It's been a few years since I've seen my penis. My belly's got too big in the days of penis. I know he's still there, but the touch alone or the occasional footy with my mobile phone. My missus sees him, says he's fine. I'd love to see for myself, you know, spend some time. So I'll eat something, we'll lose some weight, exercise, stop drinking, and lick at my plate. I'd love to see him before I die. I better shed some stones or at least get a try. Cause it's up to me to put the work in, although the missus says she'll help shag me thin. He's such a good bond, me and him. We can do again if a joint a jibbing, but there's nothing can be done for saggy boys. That's just getting old, it's one of nature's flaws. So maybe by the next time if you see me, I'll be a bit thinner, but still quite beefy. And any luck, and a slumber body, I'll be reacquainted with my Bobby, my throat's boxed up.